Not only can stress make you stronger, it is necessary to make you stronger. Without stress, you weaken. Now, of course, you need a balance between stress and recovery. And this is really based on something called a hermetic effect, where you're adding a dose of stress and then the body adapts. So the body has this urge to survive. So when you stress it, it reacts to survive more and it adapts and becomes stronger. Let's take a deeper look at what's going on here. All right, you have the immune system. You have one part of the immune system, which is the innate, which you're born with. Your mother has given you this immune system based on her stress and adaptation. But you also have what's called the acquired immune system. This is something that you develop over time. But in order to develop this part of the immune system, you have to expose it to infection. You have to go through various stresses to develop the antibodies to have a stronger immune system. In fact, you can't develop a strong immune system without being exposed to pathogens and having your body react. And this is why people that live in a sterile environment, or even especially kids, they don't have a strong immune system. They're always getting sick. And so having a sterile environment or trying to artificially boost your immune system doesn't always work. All right, then we have exercise, okay? It's a stress that breaks down muscle tissue. It actually creates damage. But then in the recovery phase, through the help of hormones, you become stronger. Versus someone who is very inactive, they actually start shrinking. They get atrophy and weaker over time. Of course, the key with exercise is that recovery. If you're not sleeping, if you're overtraining, you're not going to get any better. Number three, fasting. This is very interesting because it's counterintuitive. You would think if you starve someone or deprive them of nutrients, they would automatically get weaker, but they don't. When you deprive microbes of nutrients, they actually live longer. They become more diversified. Your body goes through all sorts of magical things, from regrowing brain cells to regrowing your immune system to healing chronic disease because the inflammation goes down to the inactivation of cancer cells. Of course, there is a limit to fasting. If you starve yourself for too long, you know, you will die. All right, number four, phytonutrients. These are the chemicals in plants. One of the purposes of a phytonutrient is to act as a pesticide or an insecticide to kill certain things that are trying to kill it and protect itself. And so when you consume some of these plants, you're getting exposed to these chemicals as well. And your body can create a hormetic effect and become stronger and resistant to it just by being exposed to a certain dose of these pesticides. Of course, the dosage is very, very small, so it's not gonna create the same effect. And usually some of these toxic chemicals in plants are very bitter, like the radish, like arugula, Swiss chard, or mustard greens. But consuming some of these things in small amounts can actually give you some benefit. All right, number five, cold therapy, cryotherapy. A cold shower or bathing in a tub of cold water can stimulate certain mechanisms to make you stronger and actually create a healing effect. Same thing can happen when you go to a hot sauna. You can create this effect. But of course, if we compare these, cold, which is more uncomfortable, can stimulate a greater improvement than using things like a sauna or a hot shower. Number six, decrease oxygen. This is called hypoxia, where you're depriving your body of a little oxygen to cause your red blood cells to adapt and become stronger. And of course, this can occur if you're training in high altitudes, on a mountaintop, and you can even exercise with certain masks to restrict the air to cause your body to actually adapt. Radiation, a small amount of radiation from the sun, for example, can cause this adaptation effect, and you actually, your body can become more resistant to it and become stronger. All right, thanks for watching. Hey, before you go real quick, I have a course entitled How to Bulletproof Your Immune System. It's a free course. I want you to take it. And here's why. Here's you. Here is your environment. Everyone is focused on this over here, avoiding your environment. But what about here? What about strengthening your immune system? That's what's missing. This course will show you how to bulletproof yourself. And so you can tolerate and resist your environment much better by strengthening your own immune system. I put a link down in the description right down below. Check it out and get signed up today.